Subscribe my channel and press the bell icon to never miss an update.
Welcome to the next episode of Daily Dreamers with Himika. Now, clean air has become one of the most pressing topics in the year gone by and will continue to be so for the next 1 year or 2 years or 10 years, quite rightfully. And today, to stay true to the cause, we have Bangalore-based clean tech Internet of Things startup Clairco, which provides a patent-pending air purification system for indoors. It offers clean air at a service by charging a monthly fee on the lines of a SaaS model. The venture has clients like Brigade, MR, Brookfield, Max Group, to name a few. And joining me today is Udyan Banerjee, the founder of Clairco. Udyan, welcome to Daydreamers with Himika.
Thank you, Himika, for having me here.
Lovely, lovely. So, Udyan, tell me something. You have just received a fresh round of funding from Sanjeev Bajaj, right? So now with the new cash coming into the kitty, what are the next plans for Clairco? What are the big things that we are looking for from your brand?
Sure. So basically, this fundraise will help us in majorly three things. First of all, we'll ramp up our tech team. Because like you said, it's a patent-pending technology and we are, you know, applying for more patents. So we'll be investing heavily on building our product in a much better way. For that, we'll be hiring a very strong tech team. Secondly, we'll also be investing in sales, ramping up our sales team. Okay. And as well as a part of it will also be set for R&D. So we are also working on some new projects, new kinds of products for which we have recently filed some patents. So for that, we need to have a R&D budget. So these are the majorly three things where this new fundraise is going to help us.
Okay. Right. So my next question would be about, see, any new innovation that comes into the market, there is normally a need and then there is a gap. So how did the idea of Clairco really happen? How did it come about?
Right. So I also have a co-founder, Ayush. He's the CEO of the company. So he and Ayush and me, we are school friends. So we are always into entrepreneurship, startups, and we are always, you know, looking out for problems, pressing problems, which we can, you know, think about and solve at a scale. So what happened is that this is a personal issue that we face. So we are from a small place called Bhilai. Both of us are from Bhilai, which is in Chhattisgarh. And then Ayush's parents moved to Delhi in 2017. And in Delhi, pollution, suddenly they became very ill. So after that, we thought about, okay, so we were talking, he bought some air purifiers, which were very expensive. So for a 3 BHK apartment, he bought almost 4 or 5 air purifiers. It cost him more than a lakh. This was like 3-4 years ago. And he was like, we were talking and wo bol raha tha ki, like, why is it so expensive? Because ultimately, it is more expensive than a mobile phone, and a mobile is a much more sophisticated technology than an air purifier, right? So it's basically a combination of fans and a fan and the filters. So what we understood is that there's a big gap. First of all, what most people are not aware, and that we also found out eventually after researching, is that indoor air pollution can be 3-4 times worse than outdoor. Right. And most people, like most of us, spend most of our times indoors. So if we can really solve, provide clean air indoors, that can save a lot of lives, because air pollution is a public health issue as well. It takes almost more than 1 million lives in India alone every year. So all this, this was a big problem to solve. And we saw if we can make it affordable and also, bring some kind of accountability in performance. So basically, that's where our tagline is about cleaner air guaranteed. So when we say guaranteed, we basically, sign a legal document where we say this will be the performance of our system. So we brought in accountability, affordability, and ease of adoption. It didn't happen in one day. We are also part of an accelerator program called Brigade Real Estate Accelerator Program, which is based out of Bangalore, which has helped us in understanding, the problem statement and what is the target market. Because initially, when we come up with the idea, we think that the entire world is going to buy it. But then we have to be really practical about it and then identify, who is going to really pay for clean air. Because honestly, people are not very aware of that. So all of us are like breathing the air, but we don't really think about clean air at every moment, right? So what we understood is that ki if we go in a B2C mode, then we'll definitely fail because people are not aware of that. So our customer acquisition cost will be very high. Alternatively, what we thought is that ki just like water purification, when it came early in the market, almost 20 years ago, it started with your 5-star hotels, grade A office spaces. They started serving purified water. And then gradually it came down to every home. And now we can't imagine having water just like that. We all of us, most of us have water purifiers and we only buy mineral waters and stuff like that. So same thing is with air also. That is what our thesis was in understanding the market. Let's go to B2B and try to provide clean air in, you know, places which are premium, where people can pay. This will increase the awareness and gradually we can, you know, trickle down to the entire market. So that's what the problem we are solving. And the adoption for air purification was very low because it was very expensive, very difficult to install, and there was no accountability of performance. Okay. These are the main pillars where we are disrupting the market. Yeah.
Got it. So can you tell me a little more about all your products one by one?
Sure. So see, what we have done is that, so we are not selling any hardware as such, but we are providing clean air as a service. What that means is that we have 5 main things that we do to a centrally air conditioned building. So any centrally air conditioned buildings will have something, a ventilation system, which is called an air handling unit. So every floor has different air handling units. So in each air handling unit, what we do is that we put air quality monitors, which are IoT devices, which can measure the air quality parameters like particulate matter, carbon dioxide, your smell, volatile organic compounds, all these whatever pollutants are in the air. Based on this data, we also put air filters onto the air handling units. So they are retrofitted on the units and they enhance the purification standards of the air handling units. So what does is that it brings down the particulate levels. So in India, 80-85% pollution is particulate matter, that is PM2.5 and PM10. You must have seen it in the news also. PM2.5 in Delhi is this much, that much, it keeps showing, right? So our filters take care of the particulate matter. Then we also install something called ultraviolet radiation technology, which takes care of the airborne microbes. So there are many pathogens flowing around in the air. It can be even COVID-19 or any kind of pathogens. So after COVID-19, what has happened, people have really become aware of this. But this problem was always there. It's not that ki COVID aaya tabhi pata chala. It was always there. But now the awareness has increased. So this is also monitoring, filtration and UV. These are the 3 things. Then we are also putting a fresh air treatment unit on the... So ultimately the air comes from outside into the building, right? So where the air comes in, that is called the fresh air intake. So there also we are putting our system to treat the fresh air. That is called the treated fresh air unit. And then all of this we are combining with the service. So all the filter maintenance, the cleaning, replacement, everything happens. So we have a patented algorithm which helps us understand when the filter needs to be replaced or cleaned. We can also, you know, combine the filter data with the air quality data and understand them. It helps us understanding when the filter needs to be cleaned or replaced, when the fresh air needs to be taken, what is the root cause of bad air. So all this helps us in understanding and guaranteeing performance.
Okay.
So we have, that's where clean air as a service comes in. And we also take the maintenance and replacement of the filters. So let's say if you are taking this service from Clearco, so you don't have to worry about, you know, the air quality. So our clients can outsource indoor air quality management to Clearco altogether. So that's what our main offering is. And regarding the COVID, what I was saying is that there are a lot of pathogens flowing in the air. And these pathogens use your particulate matter as carriers. Even COVID virus also does the same thing. So after COVID-19 outbreak, this awareness about airborne transmission of pathogens has become it has come to the limelight. But this risk was always there. So even before COVID, we were doing all these things. After COVID, we have seen a much better traction because we don't have to explain these things to our clients. they're already aware that this is a problem. So that's where our product market fit comes in.
Right. So that in fact was going to be my next question, that what has been the impact of COVID on your business? Because yours might be one of the few businesses that have only seen more acceptance among people post-COVID.
All our clients are commercial real estate. So offices, malls, schools, colleges, airports, everything was closed during lockdown, right? During those 3-4 months, it was very difficult for us because we were actually closing the fundraise last year in March. We were almost about to close the fundraise, and that's when the lockdown happened. And we actually were out of cash, and we didn't have any surety. So our fundraise didn't happen because of lockdown. And our customers also, they stopped paying because the buildings were not operating. So they were like, hey, we'll pay you later. So for the March, April, May of last year was very bad for us. And we were almost at the verge of, closing down. Then gradually, but obviously we understood, and obviously we took some tough decisions. We took a lot of pay cut, and we didn't fire anybody, but we had to take a big massive pay cut for everyone, including the founders.
Okay.
So what we figured out is that by May last year, it was clear to us that while it is a temporary problem for us, but eventually it is going to pick up because now the awareness around clean air, anything which is about safety and wellness has come to the forefront. And we are also part of the wellness offering. So gradually we started seeing that traction. And even though offices were closed, we started getting business because all these buildings are gearing up for reopening. While they're closed right now, but they're gearing up for reopening. And that's how we started getting queries. And what also helped us is that government also came up with a bunch of, guidelines for commercial buildings for reopening around air purification, and all the 5 things which we are doing were part of the guidelines.
Okay.
So that's where we saw, this is something we should cash in on. And we started our fundraise efforts again. And we started growing also. So we have been able to grow almost 25% to 30% every month post COVID. So since August, we have been growing. So March, April, May was bad. Since June last year, we are growing decently. And that's how the fundraise also happened. So our investors also, they took also cognizance of the fact that these guys are even without funds. So we were completely bootstrapping the business. We were operating it through our own profit. So our model is not of a typical B2C brand where you burn a lot of cash to acquire customers. So we are already, profitable in terms of our P&L. But the fundraise was required for obviously fast growth and building the tech team, like I said earlier. So the impact of COVID has been a mixed bag for us. Mostly good, but the initial days were very challenging and we could have closed the business.
Also, Adhiyan, what I have noticed is you are one of those few Indian startups who are running a business that can have a very strong global footprint. So are there any bigger expansion plans of moving across the boundaries of the country?
So basically this year we are going to focus entirely on India because we are at a very early stage and we want to, acquire a large chunk of the market. But parallelly, we are also planning on, launching into Middle East by, next year. Probably 1 year down the line, we should be launching in Middle East. But again, that's just in the discussion stages. But we do have global aspirations.
And what about, do you have a pan-India presence at this point?
Sorry?
Do you have a
pan-India? Yes, we do. So we have presence in most top cities. So our focus is also the tier one cities as of now. So we have presence across NCR, Bangalore, Hyderabad, Chennai, Pune, across all these cities we have presence. Mumbai and Kolkata, we have not launched as of yet, but we will soon. So mostly all the top cities we have a presence.
Yeah. Lovely. So my final question, Adhiyan, to you would be, if I would ask you to name 3 startup founders or 3 startup entrepreneurs from India who you would look up to for inspiration, then could you name them for me? 3 Indians and 3 also international. I'll ask for 3. from both sides.
Okay, sure. So India, I look up to Nitin Kamath Zaroda founders because their story is incredible. They have bootstrapped a $1 billion company, which is a very, very rare thing to do. So unicorns are rare, and then bootstrapped unicorn is almost unheard of. So Zaroda founders, then Ritesh Agrawal of Oyo. So I've worked with Oyo. I've met Ritesh also a couple of times. So Oyo was a platform where I also got to learn a lot about entrepreneurship. So before Clearco, I worked in Oyo for almost 2 to 3 years. So that was that experience has helped me a lot in becoming as an entrepreneur, as a leader in terms of learning the business skills. I was almost a fresher when I joined Oyo, and I came out as a proper I could take this risk of starting something of my own. Primarily because I saw the spark of entrepreneurship there. And then Vijay Shekhar Sharma of Paytm, that is primarily because of the patience with which they have built the business. So it started in 2000 and it is not a typical entrepreneur's wala story. This may young banda aata and within 5-6 years is. So they have built it with a very methodical manner. Right. So these three from India, from our international entrepreneurs, you can say Elon Musk is my anyway. So he's an icon. He's not just an entrepreneur. So Elon Musk is somebody whom has been.
Elon Musk is like.
Sorry.
Oh, Elon Musk is everybody's icon. Everybody.
Right. Now I'm saying other than that, I am not following any international entrepreneurs as such. So it's not on the top of my mind. So there's no one in particular. So I keep following startups, but there's no one in particular internationally whom I can say that I'm inspired by apart from Elon Musk. Yeah. Elon Musk himself is enough.
Yeah, definitely enough. Definitely. Anyway, thank you so much, Udyan, for taking time for Daydreamers with Himika. And I wish you all the very best for this wonderful cause. And cleaner air is, I think, the imperative in today's times, all the more. So thank you.
Sure. Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. Thank you so much for having me here.